I have just transmitted to the Secretary General the results of the analysis of on-site samples taken by Russian experts in Khan Al-Asal. I would like to underscore that, unlike other reports provided to the Secretary General, our samples were taken at the projectile impact point by Russian experts in person. They were not transmitted to us through third parties. In conclusion, I would like to stress that we welcome the decision by the Syrian government to invite the High Representative for Disarmament Affairs, Ms. Kane, and the head of the United Nations investigation team, Professor Sohlstrom, to visit Syria. We believe that this initiative creates a new positive momentum in order to launch an investigation into the use of chemical weapons in Syria. All modalities of such investigation should be defined in direct discussions between the Syrian government and the United Nations Secretariat. What I gave today to the Secretary General is not just a description of the results, but the actual document. It's 80 pages of photographs, formulas, and graphs, which substantiate what I have just briefly told you, and we invite the United Nations experts to study those results. Now we have something which looks like a promising process. Unfortunately, the process was derailed when the Syrian government invited this investigation of Khan Al-Asal in the first place, because what they were confronted with, this is my understanding of the predicament, was essentially the replica of Iraq investigation, and they didn't want to repeat the same experience. The situation was completely different. So now I hope that on both sides there is going to be reasonable kind of an attitude and an effort to clarify this matter. Thank you very much. Thank you. On the court debate, Ambassador, can we see the report, Ambassador?